Hello and welcome! In this video I will show you how to get new sounds from samples into the AKX10 keyboard from Medeli. Please don't bear with me if some words sound funny or I'm not grammatically always correct, because my main language is German. The AKX10 offers 768 megabytes of memory for your sounds. And with the GrandSuite program, you have a complete sound studio at your hand with which you can generate completely redesigned sounds from your samples. However, samples are only played back according to their length and not as a loop, so you should keep this in mind. It's like a mellotron, which can only hold the tones for about 8 seconds. It depends on the length of your samples, how long they will be played. I also recommend you to install the latest VLC Mediaplayer from videoland.org to preview samples and to convert 24 or 32-bit samples to 16-bit, because the GrandSuite program only supports 16-bit samples. That said, I will show you how to do this. You will go to Media. There is an option Convert Save. You can put your samples in here, one or all, as many as you like. And then you can again press on Convert and Save and use this profile, Audio CD, out of all those profiles to convert your 24 or 32-bit or 48 kilohertz samples to 16-bit 44.1 kHz samples. Be aware of selecting this field, otherwise your samples will be overwritten. And I'm sure you don't want this. Okay. It doesn't hurt to install Audacity to shorten or edit samples if necessary. I will limit myself to the basic functions in this video, because there are tons of options with which you can alienate your samples, and there are a few caveats to be aware of and a few pitfalls that I will also address. For example, you should first connect your keyboard via USB cable and let Windows recognize it before you start the software. Yes, the program only runs under Windows. After connecting your keyboard, turning it on, you can start the program and you will find your keyboard under the device section here. At the moment mine is disconnected, let's press connect. It will be found automatically and you will be asked if you want to use the sound list from your keyboard, and that's okay. The next thing is the audio output, and there is a first stumbling block here. You can use your internal Windows audio sound card or Windows audio media to hear the sound, but there is a big problem. Windows audio uses 48 kilohertz, but the program needs 44.1 kilohertz. So if you use another sound card, you have to set it to 44.1 kilohertz output. Otherwise, the pitch of all plain samples shifts up by 3¼ of a tone, or by 75 cents. And that sounds not right. After exporting, that's okay, it's right on your keyboard, but I'm sure you want to listen your samples in the right pitch. So I recommend you to use your Medeli keyboard as the audio output. And now all sounds will be played out of the speakers from your keyboard. And I'm using this and recording the output of the keyboard right into my PC, so we can hear it while I'm recording this. You will find the manual and instructions here under this book symbol. They are very rudimentary. You have to try out which function has which effect. Trust me, you will have to try out, and nevertheless, I strongly advise you to take a look at this instruction. especially when it comes to exporting the data in a suitable format to your keyboard. Be aware of that there are some options and have a look inside the manual. Okay, so you can see there are four main sections for style, arpeggio, sound, and release. And we will go to sound. Here we can open an existing sound we've created out of samples and rework on it. We can create a new drum kit sound or a new general sound. And we will create a new general sound now. As you can see, there is a full range keyboard from C minus to C9. And here is a red bar that shows the keyboard area of your keyboard. And everything below or above this red bar have to be selected with the octave buttons later on your keyboard. Okay, you can load samples with a plus symbol here. You can delete them and you can listen to them solo or mute them with these four buttons. You can layer up to, not 8, but 40 samples. Yes, you can layer 40 samples and you can set the velocity range. So in a lower velocity, you will hear sample number 1, layer 1, and in a higher velocity, you will hear layer number 2 or some of them together. So you are free to layer your own voices and sounds and thus up to 40 layers. Okay, I will put in my first sample with a plus symbol. And you can also import existing sounds you've created off of samples. I will get back later on this. I will choose one sample out of my sources. And these are samples from a Roland D50 synthesizer. And I've converted my 32-bit samples to CD quality. And let's take one guitar sound. And yes, as you can see, I've got a lot of samples here. And if I take this one sample and open it, you will see that it will be stretched over the entire keyboard. And that means that the pitch of all notes is now generated from this one sample. This may work over a few notes, but with most of the samples, it doesn't sound good anymore. And for this reason, you should have more samples at different pitches. And my samples from the D50 are available always one sample for 3 semitones. And you can grab the ends and define the range of your sample by grabbing and pushing and pulling it to the notes you want them to be. Let's have a listen. I'm not sure that this is right. Let's re-listen the source sample, the C2 sample. And as you can hear, this sounds lower. That's because you have to tell the program the source note of your sample. And that can be done under pitch. And as you can see, as I said, your velocity range can be set here. If I want to play this only in the velocity of 1 to 40, I will drag this thing here over to 40, and then it will be only played with a velocity of 40. As you can see, nothing happens. If I drag the velocity down to under 40, the note will be played. So you can layer up to 40 samples and give them special velocity so you have layered sounds at the end. Okay. But back to the pitch. As I said, you have to tell the program the original note, and my guitar C2 sample is from the C3. Don't be confused about that. I recently noticed it myself. but we will tell the program the original note is from C3. And now when we play it, it will sound like the original sample. Not as loud because the velocity is not set to 100. And now we can get our next sample, not the C2, but the D sharp 2 sample, and drag it over here. And I will push it down. And again, I have to tell the program its original pitch. And so you will put in your samples over the entire keyboard as much as you need, as much as you like. You can put any sample on any note you like. And at the end, you will maybe end up with something like this. I will show you. I will open an existing sound. You can open a sound and rework on it, but you also can import an existing sound, and I already created two of them, the mono guitar sound, and as you can see, I've placed all my samples. I set the pitch, the original pitch of my sample, and you can detune if you like, scent wise, and now it sounds like this. Okay, maybe you want to make your sound more interesting, then you could save and import it just again. Again, I will click on the plus sign and import my guitar mono sound again, and it will automatically put to the next layer. And then I will pen this layer hard to the left side, and I will pen this side to the right side. And now I've got a stereo sound, of course, out of two similar mono sounds, so I have to do something more that it becomes a nice stereo sound. I will go to the pitch section and detune each side a little bit. I will detune this side 5 cents up, and I will detune this side 5 cents down. And now we've got a really nice stereo phaser effect. Unfortunately, due to the way I record this, you can't hear it in stereo, but believe me when I tell you that this really, really sounds great. You can also set some longer release time for every layer, so the key off is a little bit longer, the sound is a little bit longer. Of course, you have to do it more or less the same. Okay, at the end, we want to save our sound, and then we want to export and import it into our keyboard. And I will click on the diskette symbol to save it. I already have one stereo sound, so I will abort this. And after saving, we will go to the release section here. Unfortunately, it's not possible just to export and import a new sound. You have to create an expansion package, and that is the only way you can import new sound styles, arpeggios into your AKX10 keyboard with this expansion package. And any previously imported expansion pack will be overwritten. You can merge older expansion packs to one new, so you don't have to do this all again and again and again. From this section, you can create a new package by clicking on the plus symbol. And there was a question from one viewer if it's possible to import SF2 packages. And yes, it is in this section. You can import SF2 packages to create new packages, expansion packages out of your SF2 files. I want to create a new pack and I will give it the name D50 because I want to put all my Roland D50 sounds into it on a later time. And as you can see, there is a folder created and you can now put sounds, styles, drum sounds and arpeggios into this. You can also set the bank where it will be created after importing, and I will click the plus symbol to put my sounds into this, the mono sound and the stereo sound. And as you can see, there are some more options of files you can import this. And the next step, there is a question about how you want to export your expansion pack, because it depends on whether the pack should only work on your own or any other AKX keyboard. If it should only work on your own, you must first import your keyboard configuration file from your keyboard using a USB stick. The keyboard configuration file can be found in the global settings under config and the config page form. There you can export it onto a USB stick, then import it into the GrandSuite software. And after importing and using your configuration file, your expansion pack can only be imported onto your device. You can remove these restrictions by clicking here. Please refer to the manual for more options. As I said in the beginning, there are three options to export this. In this case, I want to create my expansion pack that works only on my device. At the end, I click on export and give it a name, D50 pack. And as you can see, it creates an MPK file. And this file is the one to put on your USB stick, take it to your keyboard, and then import this package into your keyboard. That's all I have for you. We've created our own sound and put this into an expansion pack and imported it into our keyboard. Thank you for watching. If you have any further questions, put them in the comment section below. Stay healthy and have fun playing your instrument. Until next time.